Down here.
The show starts in 5 seconds. I hope. What was five? Oh, five. What was four? Four. Because it's the ones down. Mm-hmm. Yeah. Four. Oh, three. Yeah. We all know that one, right? Yeah. And two. Mm-hmm. That's a hang loose. Mm-hmm. And showtime.
Oh, wait.
Oh, well, ow. We start with the family therapy. Yep. Oh, what else is new?
Were you going to say something?
What is the difference between freedom and kingdom? And just plain dumb.
Not much.
Could you get that one of those roadies over there to hand us the... I can't do a show without my bloody hat.
Oh, you got a feather in it, though.
Yeah. I thought that looked a little bit kind of woke, kind of PC, a little gay. You know what I mean? Yeah.
You got a low threshold for what you think looks gay.
So this one is for going out to Ray Charles and Don Gibson. And I got to get my pics on here, so you make some jokes, Bob.
You know my girlfriend's uncle wrote this song.
Oh, you mean Jill Gibson?
Yeah.
Are you living through me?
Yeah, back in the...
I know that
back
I...
in 1960.
Okay, I'll tell you something heavy about that. I know I did this. They make their parents' dreams come true, even though they don't know they're doing it.
Well,
they do what the parent was trying to do, and that DNA...
Okay, well, that's the whole point of parenting, is that you get... And the line is that you're all moving closer to the goal. So if you don't get to there, at least you should help get your kid a little further.
It is the evolution.
And then they can get a little further for their kid.
It's the evolution of the DNA.
Just got to make sure you're going somewhere good.
The evolution of the DNA. And it's also the impetus of the evolution in your brain.
Oh.
Going out to Don Gibson and Ray Charles, and it was actually my girlfriend. I can't stop loving you. Said I made up my mind to live in the memory of a lonesome time. I can't stop wanting you. Oh, it's just useless to say. So I've just live my life in dreams of yesterday.
Dreams of yesterday.
Those happy hours.
Those happy hours.
That we once knew.
That we once knew.
So long ago.
So long ago.
They still make me blue.
Still make me blue.
You know they say that time.
Say the time.
It is a broken heart.
Here's a broken heart.
Hey, but the time is too still since we've been apart. Hey, I can't stop loving you. I said I made up my mind to live in the memory. Oh, a lonesome time. Now I can't stop wanting you. Oh, it's just useless to say. So I'll just live my life in dreams of yesterday.
dreams of yesterday.
Am I going?
Yeah.
Yesterday.
Yeah.
All my troubles seem so far away. Now it looks as though they're here to stay. Oh, I believe in Merle Haggard. Today I started loving you again. Now I'm right back where I really always been. I got over you just long enough to let my heartache mend. And then today I started loving you again.
Yeah, today I started loving you again.
Oh, what a fool I was to think I could get by. Only these few million tears I cry. Oh, how will I to know the worst was yet to come? In that crying time for me it just begun. And in the day I started loving you. Now I'm right back where I really always been. I got over you just long enough to let my heartache mend. And then today I started loving you again. And then today I started loving you again. And then today I started loving you again. Yeah, old Merle Haggard. And who are the little girls down in Australia?
Sapphires.
The Sapphires, they're really good. I really enjoyed them. Yes, I did. Listening to them. I don't get that stuff out of your mind. You know what I mean?
I didn't have it in my mind.
What is the difference between freedom, kingdom, and just plain dumb?
Huh? What is it?
I don't know. I got to look up those words. I'm going to get freedom because I think freedom means a bunch of different things to different people.
Yeah.
I don't think people really want to be really, really free. If they really want to be really, really free, they'd just pack up a little kit, start walking out into the bush, be free.
Yeah.
Totally. There's still a bunch of bush left. No. Even in places I didn't think there was, like India and stuff like that, there's bush everywhere.
Yeah.
It's just nobody wants to live in the bush because everybody's social. They want to get into the beehive, into the city.
Plus, there's like things that can kill you in the
bush. The city is like a human beehive, isn't it, Mom?
It is, Dad. It's a human hive.
Have you got a song for that? Oh, we got to get out. Oh, we didn't even tell them about the limo. The limo is coming for you in 5, 4, 3, 2, 1. I can't do all those things again. And we're going to take a ride out in the country. So just slide on into the back of the old limo there. It's Patsy Cline and Hank Williams used to ride in the back there. So I think that's pretty cool. Now. We're gonna take a ride.
Gonna take a ride.
We're gonna take a ride.
We're gonna take a ride.
I'll pass the honky tonk.
Pass the honky tonk.
And pass the county line.
And pass the county line.
Through the amber waves of grain.
Through those waves of grain.
And past the dairy cow.
With their big brown eyes.
To the old cornfield of dreams.
Cornfield, cornfield.
Like Kevin Costner's. When it's not baseball players, it's old singers, and they come out and they request their songs. They got a still in their corn liquor. Who's coming out, Mom?
Oh, it's George Jones.
Only Maul can see him. But I got first-hand knowledge because she can see him. George is here.
George is here.
He showed up.
Yeah.
Does he look okay?
Yeah.
Is Tammy here?
No.
Oh, okay. So we're not singing Golden Ring then?
Nope. We're singing She Thinks I Still Care.
Okay, George. Here we go. Doesn't sound like you, boy, but sounds like something. Yeah, baby. And my childhood wasn't that great either. Never did see a rubber room.
No.
No.
No, just because.
I got Burl Haggard on my butt.
I know.
No, that was Ray.
Yeah. Yeah.
I was starting the show over. Okay, hold it. No, let me get it straight then. Good. Yeah, okay, I got it. Got it. Silly girl. She really thinks it. You know, Elvis actually did this song, and John Fogerty, too.
Oh, nice.
Not quite as good as us, but... Just because I asked a friend about her. Just because I spoke her name somewhere. Just because I rang her number by mistake today. She thinks I still care. Nobody did it like George, though. If she's happy to sing, I still need it. Let that silly notion bring her cheer. I got it. Oh, how could she ever be so foolish? Oh, where would she get such an idea? Oh. Just because I haunt the same old places where the memory of her lingers everywhere. Just because I saw her then went on to pieces. She thinks I still care. She thinks I still care. She thinks I still care. June. No, he's good, eh?
Yeah.
You listen to him. He's good.
You can start crying. Just talking about George.
No, never mind. I'm not John Boehner. You never knew John Boehner.
I never did.
Well, he must have been a brilliant guy. He was the head of the house, or he was the speaker of the house, or whatever.
What house?
The White House. The American politics, man. And he would cry really easily.
Yeah.
When the Pope came over, he just broke up.
Oh.
Now that I read, this is quite funny, Ma. You know, I had to read my hind quarter,
yeah.
My left hind quarter, and I got it, like, actually tougher than the other one.
Yeah.
Oh, you know, it's all out of whack. They don't go together, and,
yeah.
You know. Still dance. Anyways, no, but I thought when I get the pool finished.
Yeah.
Might be a while. A few shows from now. And I finally get back in the water, you know, because I used to be a champion swimmer, among other things. I was a champion of all fishermen, you know, that couldn't swim.
Yeah.
I think when I get back in the pool, because of the way it's like cockeyed,
mm-hmm.
I'm going to take off. It's going to feel like $1 million because that side is like so good.
Yeah.
But I think I'll go around in circles like this.
Because you got one straw.
Yeah, but one is different from the other. I'll be going in circles.
Yeah.
And you know what? John Sabota,
yeah.
He used to squeeze bullheads, heads. Uh-huh. He'd get the bullhead out and he'd squeeze it. That's a fish. Mm-hmm. He'd squeeze that little bullhead's head, mm-hmm. and then he'd throw him back in the water, and the bullhead couldn't stop. He just kept going round and round.
Why did he do that?
Brain damage, I guess.
No, but why did John Sabota do that?
Some, you know, just wanted to...
Just a psychopath? Yeah.
Yeah.
Nice.
I didn't stay there and watch. Horrible things.
Ugh, I don't want to hear about it.
Well, they're trying to cure it now with the political correctness.
Yeah.
They figure if they say it,
yeah,
it's going to happen.
Yeah.
No.
No.
I don't think it changes your DNA.
No, I think they
I think it takes millions of years to do that.
I think a politically correct environment is a perfect place for a psychopath to hide.
Absolutely. Yeah. Absolutely. Words have little to do with just exactly who you are. You know, unless you're careful about what... What's this?
I think we could sing a song now.
Okay. Well, that's pretty cool. What is it?
Big River and Moving On.
You know, I know some indie rock bands that really like this.
Oh, yeah?
Yeah. I think we're going to go big all over on different, what do you call them?
Platforms? Waves? Yeah. Genres?
Genres. Yeah. Genre. That's French. different genres. We can do them all. We can do them all.
Yeah.
Okay?
Let's do it.
And we do it with Johnny Cash and Hank Snow. You know, this song held the number one for about a million weeks
yeah.
in 1951. What? Or three.
1 million
weeks.
It was
weeks. Either one or three.
There's a lot of weeks.
There's a biggie. We love moving down the track. And me too, love and dad ain't come back. And I'm moving on. Yeah. And, of course, we all know Johnny Cash, right? But a lot don't know who Hank Snow was. He was a short little man from Nova Scotia, Canadian.
Little fisherman?
Yep. Hank Snow and the Singing Rangers, Mom. But we don't sound up. Did he come out? Or who came out? John? Are we still at the...
No, George came out. Oh, yeah, we're still in the cornfield.
Yeah, okay, they came out. Okay. They came out. Well, I thought the weeping willow had a cry, cry, cry. Showed the cloud had a cover of a clear blue sky. Oh, man, you know the tears I cried, but that woman gonna flood you, big river. And I'm gonna sit right here until I die.
I'm gonna sit right here until I die.
Well, I met her accidentally. St. Paul, Minnesota. Tore me up every time I heard that drawl, heard the southern drawl. Oh, you took my dream back downstream, cavorting in a Davenport. And then I followed you, big river, when you called.
Followed you, big river, when you called.
Oh, me to St. Louis later on, down the river. Freda said she's been here, boy, but she's gone, boy, she's gone. Well, I found her trail in Memphis. She just walked up the block. She raised a few eyebrows and she went down alone.
She raised a few eyebrows and she went down alone.
Hey, don't you batten down my Baton Rouge, River Queen, rolling on. Take that woman on down, down to New Orleans, down to New Orleans. Oh, go on, I've had enough. Dump my blues way down in the Gulf. I said that she loves you, big river, more than me.
She loves you, big river, more than me.
Well, I taught the weeping willow how to cry, cry, cry. Showed that cloud how to cover of a clear blue sky. Oh, man, you know the tears I cry, but that woman don't flood you, big river. And I'm gonna sit right here until I die, or until I see a big eight-wheeler. There's a big eight-wheeler moving down the track. I mean, your true love and daddy come back. And I'm moving on. Yeah, I'm a rolling on.
I'm rolling.
You were flying too high in my little old sky, and I'm moving on. Oh, Mr. Fireman, won't you please listen to me? Cause I got a pretty mama down in Tennessee. Okay, moving me on.
Keep moving on.
Keep rolling on.
Keep rolling on.
Oh, keep a shovel in the coal. Keep rattling the road and keep moving on. Well, you switch your engine, ain't got time. No trapping woman on my main line. Keep moving on,
keep moving on.
Hey, keep a rolling on,
keep rolling on.
You hit the left on me and I set you free and I'm moving on. You're gonna ease my mind, put me there on time. Keep rolling on. Yeah. I like to be scatting, doing the scat man, scatting thing.
Yeah.
You know, I can never say that word again now that I found out it's another, means has another meaning. Scatting while you're ooh.
Yeah.
You're oohing.
Yeah.
I'm scatting.
Yeah.
Scat ooh. Scat ooh.
Yeah.
Just made that up. That's what this show is all about, Mom, making shit up.
Well, let's get out of the cornfield, Dad, or we're going to be stuck in
here. Yeah, we better, because we've been stuck there for... Okay.
Everybody get back in the limo. We got to get on the old country road, that old county line road.
All the girly toes.
All the girly toes.
Hanging out of the window.
Hanging out of the window.
After having a shot of that corn liquor, Mom. Somebody sees a great big tower.
Woo!
500,000 watts. Station GHRT. Is there for you and me. Brought to you by Alice's Restaurant and General Store. Anything you want.
Down at Alice's Restaurant.
Oh, down at Alice's Restaurant. Pull in the station, go up to the front desk and see Betty Page there. She's in the cigarette girl uniform. She's got your tea. The Hiawaska in it. I'm gonna send you down the stairs here to the psychedelic prairie home companion. Three chords and truth. The really big old time medicine show, Three Chords and the Truth, starring Molly Griffin and your old dog Bird.
And the Reverend Dr. Joe G2 coming to you live from Station GHRT in the virtual haystack in your mind, where the show always starts in 5 minutes. I don't spin the tunes on the turntable, we spin them on our souls. So kick back, chill out, and relax for the mellow sounds of the singing DJs.
Spin them on our souls. Sometimes we spin them on our arsehole. Ba-dee-o-bee-o, ba-bo, ba-dee-o, ba-dee-o, ba-bo, rum, ba-ba-dee-o, ba-dee-o, bo. Ba-ma-ma-ma-ma-ma-ma-ma-ma-ma-ma-ma-ma-ma-ma, Mr. Sandman.
Yes?
Okay, could you remember that one? Because I like it. We do it every time. Trademark.
Never remember it again.
Okay, let's kick the show off with a big what do you call them? Beatitude.
All right.
And then you can put a song to this, okay? Because
song
every show's a game. Every game's a show, because that's all your brain does, puzzle games and stories. If you catch your brain doing anything that you can't categorize as a puzzle game and story, we got to know down at the psychological laboratory right away, because we need all the vetting we can get.
Yes.
Try hair. Oh, my God. Is that your hair?
No.
No, it must have been one of the girls from Australia.
Well, now my brain's going.
Shut up. It's not as bad as scatting. Okay, do ye know what God gave us to counter focus and the law of attraction?
What?
What did God give us to counter focus and the law of attraction, which is how you get everything done, right?
Fear.
No, he gave us the law of distraction. I'm starting a new thing, Ma. It's the law of distraction. What can we do?
But I will tell you, as a person who is distracted, you are more you're more easily distracted when you are stressed out and scared.
Oh, well, I know all about that. You mean you can't think clear. I know. Yeah. That's why there's so...
Your distraction is trying to escape from whatever is in front of you.
I know, because in my industry, you couldn't get many people that could think on their feet.
Yeah.
When you found a guy that could think on his feet and you could throw orders at him, he'd go around doing all these things, scurry around, do all that. But, you know, he usually rose up into management. Yeah. Anyway.
But, like, the kids, the ADD kids are sitting in the classroom and can't focus on the lesson. It's because they don't want to. And they hate being there. And they hate it. And they're trying to escape in their minds.
That's right. And you're talking about purpose and meaning. You see, even when you're small, that door number one, purpose and meaning. There's only three doors, right, Ma?
Yeah.
Door number one, purpose and meaning. Door number two, order and security, fair play and all that crap. Mm-hmm. And door number three, connection to nature, symbiotic relation with nature. Mm-hmm. It's all in there, and you can just start a conversation and keep going, oh, that's door number one. Oh, that's door number two. And that's when the big game comes out. That's what it's going to be. Okay. Who can get that? Is that, what door is that? You get it. I can get it. Me. You. Door number four. No. You're out. Maybe there should be a mysterious door number four, Mo, for like the spiritual end of things. No, that's in door number three.
Remember you had veg in there for a while?
Meditation. Oh, yeah, probably. You can tell me later. Yeah. All right. But anyway, she's coming together hard and fast. All right, here we go.
So we got time for one more song, Dad. Do you want?
And what would be to your liking? Do you have something that follows it?
Do you want I Shall Be Released or do you want Two Pina Coladas? Because I think they both follow that beatitude quite well.
Maybe Two Pina Coladas in this show, don't you think?
Yeah.
Because I'm not really ready.
That was my original
ready
plan.
To get... I mean, the other one is more spectacular, but it's more...
Uh-oh.
You know.
Uh-oh, Dad. Put it on a bee, Dad.
I will. Speaking of bees, Ma, I told you about the guy I watched the other day. Holy crap, gee, I didn't know nothing about bees. I didn't know nothing about bees, and he got up on the top of his camper, and... There was a big hive of bees. He said there were 50,000 bees in there. Mm-hmm. And he said, and he's going, it's the march. You're going to love the march. You wait till you get the march. And then he pulled them down to have a look at them and see what mood they are in. He wanted to see what mood they're in, but they're really angry. He might not do it right then. And anyways, he pulled it down like that. And he went, oh, my good God. And he went like that and he grabbed the queen. Mm-hmm. Because usually he has to find the queen when he does his thing, right?
Right.
He grabbed the queen, put it in the box. And he said, oh, this is cool. You're going to really see the march right away now. Yeah. And then he walks over to these bees and he shakes them. 50,000 bees land on the top of his truck. And some spill over the sides. Yeah. And then a few start going at him. And he goes, yeah, they're not that good at mood. I said they're like not really bad, but they're not like really good either. And he starts getting bitten. And then all the bees start going up.
Yeah.
You know, you couldn't actually see them marching. They didn't have rifles or anything. But, you know, they start. And it all goes up in that box. I never knew nothing about this.
Yeah, bees are cool.
Totally cool. And this guy was like totally cool too, because it's always great to see someone who's got their eight ball in the pocket.
Yeah.
Right? He's just like blown.
Yeah.
And he's been doing this for ages and he's still blown by it. That's why I saw a little bit of a Joe Rogan thing the other night, and he's saying, I'll tell you what's wrong with you guys out there.
Yeah.
You're sitting in those cubicles and he says, what you got to do is you got to get your own life. You know, for instance, I know a guy who makes furniture.
Yeah.
And that's what he does. He makes the best bloody furniture you could ever see. He never gets in a traffic jam. He never gets, you know what I mean? Saying, we got to change.
Yeah.
You know, you can't let this industrial, you know what I'm talking about, Mom?
I know what you're talking about.
Maybe we should sing I Shall Be Released. No. Okay.
Two pina coladas and then we're done.
Chill out to this old Garth Brooks tune. This is before he went to rock.
Yeah.
This is, what is it called? Alternate personality?
Yeah.
How'd that go for you?
Alter ego.
How'd that go for you guys?
He evolved, Dad.
He's a funny guy. Have you ever seen his thighs?
No, I want to sing his song.
He was on one of the talk shows.
No,
he's sitting there
thighs.
In tight jeans, and he has his legs crossed. Holy crap, Ola. Huge. Huge. Yeah.
He's a mesomorph. Endomorph.
Yeah.
Which
what?
One?
Okay.
Endomorph.
Alpha male. Okay, what are you singing?
I was feeling the blues.
I can do this. I was feeling the blues, watching the news. This fella came on TV. He said, I'm telling you, science is proof. Heartache is healed by the sea. That got me going without even knowing. I packed right up and drove down. I'm on a roll and I swear to my soul, tonight I'm gonna paint this town. Oh, bring me two pina coladas, one for each hand. Setting sail on a Captain Morgan, I ain't never gonna leave dry land. Troubles, I forgot them. Yeah, I buried them in the sand. Bring me two pina coladas and say goodbye to your good time man.
Oh, bring me two pina coladas and say goodbye to your good time man.
Oh, now I gotta say that the wind and the waves, the moon winking down at me, eases my mind by leaving behind a heartache love often brings. I got this smile and it goes on for miles with no inclination to roam. And I gotta say, I think that I'm gonna stay, cause this is feeling more and more like home. Oh, bring me two pina coladas, one for each hand. I'm setting sail on a Captain Morgan. I ain't never gonna leave dry land. Troubles, I forgot them. Yeah, I buried them in the sand. Bring me two pina coladas and say goodbye to your good time and man. Oh, bring me two pina coladas and say goodbye to your good time and mine.
Say goodbye to your good time and mine.
Oh, yeah.
What? That's a first.
You know, we're making this shit up, but it doesn't always come out perfect. You know, you got to take risks in life. Or not. You have to, for your brain to evolve and to be happy, because all you got to do is cooperate with your crocodile who's totally obsessed with evolving. Creative growth and development. Read all about it down at Griffin Art Patreon. And listen, you know why you want to do that? Because when you got your health, you got just about everything. So y'all come back now, you hear? And I know you got problems over there, and I'm not even going to talk about them because it'll date the show, but London, France, and underpants. Get them up, pull them up. Belarus and China. If you got your health, you got just about everything, and good crackdown in Ireland, and y'all come back now, yeah?